right, here we are at DrupalCon. Michael, thanks for joining us.
It's my pleasure.
So Michael is a presenter who was part of Pantheon's Partner Day a second time this year, which is great. Michael is now with a new firm called Ankura, and you work on a lot of agency acquisitions, helping agencies get ready for that process and get through that process. Can you just start by giving us a little background on yourself and Ankura?
Yeah, so I've been in investment banking for about 25 years. I've closed over 80 deals. The last 5 years I've been focused on digital media companies, specifically digital media agencies, where I was working at a company called Ad Media Partners. We sold a company called Media Current, which is, you know, one of the initial sales of digital media agency that focused on Drupal.
Yep.
That was sold to Code and Theory. And then we subsequently got hired by Code and Theory to sell them to the Stagwell Group. So my background is in capital raising, M&A. I've also done some consulting, and with a lot of focus on the digital media agency space.
Awesome. We actually just had a conversation with Media Current earlier today, so we know them well, and they're obviously a significant customer for us at Pantheon. So. We love the work that they're doing. I think that Media Current actually is an interesting example for other agencies in the ecosystem to take a look at. We talked a little bit about the way that they embraced agility in their business and started operating in a different way. That allowed them to sort of transition their business to more of a retainer model. I'm curious if you can speak to how significant is something like that for an agency being able to get through that transformation as they start thinking about an acquisition in the future?
Yeah, it's very important. So, and it's changed over the last 5 years. So one of the first questions that we get when we approach a potential buyer about a digital media agency is what kind of recurring revenue, what percentage of recurring revenue do they have? So I think that kind of transition that Media Current made has been very successful. It's something that the market is more and more focused on, the buyer's market. And it's the issue with the project-based company is that a lot of these clients are 3 or 4 months clients and then they're out. Yep. So I think that if digital media agencies can figure out how to focus, go a little bit higher up the food chain, give more strategy to their clients, user interface, UI and UX, those kind of services are more apt to, you know, go to a retainer-based, recurring-based revenue model, and that's becomes more attractive.
Yeah, so you're touching on, I think, an important issue or trend in the marketplace, which is that there's kind of a convergence that's taking place. One of the things that I'm seeing is that the biggest consultancies out there, the BCGs, the McKinseys, the Accentures and Deloittes of the world, they have really started building out their digital transformation practices. I mean, they're full-fledged practices at this point. They have done a lot of agency acquisition to actually not just do the consulting piece, but actually start doing delivery to their customers. So that's sort of like downward pressure that's heading into the market. At the other end of the spectrum, you've got agencies like Media Current and others that are working in a different way where they can be more consultative and they're trying to actually go up market. How do you see that playing out?
Yeah, so we see three different bulbs there when we look at it, or spheres. So you have the traditional holding companies which have provided the traditional advertising agencies, marketing services kind of companies.
Yep.
Then you have the consulting firms and then you have the IT services firms. They're all converging and it's all around client and delivery. So with somebody like an Accenture who just last week announced that they're buying Droga5, who's a very high profile creative agency, that's a really good example. There's another company that Accenture bought 5 or 6 years ago called Fjord, which is a Scandinavian based company. That's been, you know, tremendously successful for Accenture. So What the Accentures and the BCGs of the world are doing is they're saying, listen, we have a lot of technology resources, but we aren't that great on the creative side. So let's pick up some of these creative agencies, and then we can actually bring them in-house and we can kind of fill them out with our, you know, technology services in the back end. So that's a big trend on the IT services firms, which we're seeing become much more aggressive in this market. They provide a lot of back of the house services, working with a media current or a creative digital media agency.
Yeah.
That's much higher up the food chain for them. So they can basically bring in potentially new clients and then offer the back of the house services. And this is at a much higher billing rates and a much better business model.
Yeah.
So we see that convergence, it's been very prevalent over the last 5 years, and we see that continuing.
So we talked about recurring revenue already and the importance that that has in factoring in the valuation of the agency, but what are the other factors that agencies should be aware of as they think about taking steps in this journey?
So, you know, it's the one thing that a question I get asked a lot is, what's more important, is it revenue growth or profitability? And unfortunately, we have to answer that question, it's both.
Yeah. Okay.
Because if you throw everything out to just focus on revenue growth, these companies in the digital media agencies are all, they're all valued on profitability and EBITDA specifically. So,
yeah.
So you can't just totally focus on revenue growth without having a, you know, a profitable business model. So we usually look at a 15% EBITDA margin, adjusted EBITDA margin as a rule of thumb. But it's very important for, you know, listen, it's also, it, I'm not saying it's not important to have revenue growth, because that's going to be very important as well. So when you're, if you're preparing, you're thinking about doing an exit and you have an agency, you need to focus on both of those. You also need to focus on, you know, having recurring revenue. What kind of services are you offering your customer? Where is your differentiation in the marketplace? Because a lot of the sales points that you have when you're selling to your clients are also going to be important in the sale process as well.
So we talked a little bit about profit margin is one factor. And one of the things that agencies can do to improve their profit margins is to improve their productivity and to be more efficient in the work they do. That is very much the space that Pantheon occupies, right? We help web teams, particularly within the agency, operate in a much more efficient manner through automation and other agile workflows. I'm curious, how do you see technologies like Pantheon helping agencies, and do you look at those when you're evaluating an agency?
Well, I think it's important to, you know, we look at the overall technology that the agency has and the skills on the technology side. So by having somebody like Pantheon enable them to be more profitability, that's a big plus when it comes to a sale. So, you know, we think that there's other different factors that, you know, it can be, okay, I've got a very strong Drupal, or I may have a strong WordPress, or I may be very strong in marketing automation.
Sure.
You know, anything, again, that makes your firm distinctive when you're going out and trying to distinguish yourself among your competitors, that's also going to help us on the sales side as well.
Yeah, and they may have, there may be different tool sets that they have to deploy for those different contexts and different specialties. That makes sense. One thing that I just mentioned for those of you watching this, we actually recently did a study, a total economic impact study with Forrester. And this report really starts to document and pull apart the value that services like Pantheon brings. We saw that for external development teams, agencies, it was like a 4x benefit for developers there. And for internal teams, it was about 2.5x for developers on board. So these kinds of things can make a big difference when it comes to a lever. It is an important lever that they have to change the margin of their business.
Oh, absolutely. That's, you know, and that also goes to how well these businesses are run, because if you're running it efficiently, I mean, that's what people want to see. They want to, another factor that people look at is, how is the management structure of the company that they're buying?
Yeah.
Is it reliant upon one owner or two key people, or is there a second level of management structure? And how the business is run and how it's managed it translates into profitability. So having a partner like Pantheon will, you know, gives them the ability to actually stand out in the processes that we run.
Well, Michael, this has been super helpful. Thank you for coming back and spending a few minutes talking with me. I enjoyed our conversation.
I did as well. Thank you very much.